on this opportunity to accumulate health, we're talking about, does copper and zinc cancel each other out? Does taking those minerals, can you not take them together? Now, I hear this often, and especially in regards to supporting iron deficiency, as you know, the product we created that has been so crazy helpful and efficient at raising ferritin levels and normalizing iron contains both copper and zinc. So I think we need to get down to the bottom of this and shed some light here, because I don't think it's what we're all thinking it is. So it is invaluable to understand that just because a nutrient can potentially affect absorption or utilization of another nutrient doesn't mean it does in all cases, at all times. So as with so many nutrients, it is the dose, you know, the concentration, the ratios that make all the difference. And this is just how it is with copper and zinc. So when you think about eating a whole food, they have countless nutrients that could interact with each other, but do not cause excess or deficiencies when consumed in the whole food form, right? So once we jump to supplemental nutrients, in most cases, you know, we're utilizing vitamins and minerals completely outside of their natural matrix. Doesn't mean they can't be helpful. Doesn't mean they're bad for us, but they are not in, you know, the apple. They are outside. They've been extracted out. So getting right here to the point is consuming copper and zinc in supplemental form, it could potentially throw you off or could be of no effect. So when copper supplementation exceeds about 10 milligrams per day on a regular basis, you potentially could start seeing zinc depletion. Potentially. I mean, taking 10 milligrams of copper a day, I'm not sure why anybody would take 10 milligrams of copper a day anyway. That's a lot. You're probably gonna get more, you know, potentially copper toxic by doing that all the time. Then you're gonna need to worry about zinc, but there's that. On the other side, with zinc supplementation, basically exceeding about 40 milligrams per day consistently, also potentially could create a copper deficiency. Now, this could take months, could take years, could take decades, may never happen. But keeping those numbers in mind, you know, they're not written in stone, but they're great numbers to keep in mind to ensure that you are not overwhelming your system with one mineral at the cost of another. And I think most commonly we see it in zinc, and most of the studies are related to zinc affecting copper. But you know, these are mostly case studies. They're not like population studies showing this huge problem with copper or zinc supplementation and causing deficiencies. So the reason we'd even talk about copper and zinc and issues related to their supplementation and deficiencies is that copper and zinc share a common absorption pathway in the digestive tract. So if there's a bunch of one mineral present, it will dominate and inhibit absorption of the other. So if you got all, you're taking all zinc and copper's trying to get in there, it's not. There's going to be so much zinc present that those are going to overwhelm the uptake pathways. So when these minerals, though, are in their physiological doses, like say found in whole foods or whole food supplements, this isn't a problem because the absorption pathways are not overwhelmed. And this is a big deal because nearly every known immune building, connective tissue repairing, antioxidant defense pathway utilizes both copper and zinc. Now, for instance, the antioxidant enzyme superoxide dismutase, you know, this is such a powerful protector of cells from excess oxidation, you know, irritation and damage from toxic insults. This antioxidant enzyme requires both zinc and copper. If you don't have copper, it can't do its work. If you don't have zinc, it can't do its job. So on the immune front, you know, we need zinc to optimally have our immune system, you know, function, our cellular immune function to perform optimally. And we need, and for signaling of those immune cells, we got to have zinc. Whereas copper, you know, it's essential for the development and the maturing or the maintenance of immune cells. So without either one of them, you're going to end up in a tough space related to your immune system. And if you've been taking high levels of copper or zinc, or you're maybe you're experiencing delayed wound healing, getting sick all the time, you feel like, man, I'm just not recovering very fast. I get sick and it just takes forever for me to get back on top of it. Or you're showing up, you're anemic. Or you have hair loss, hair's not growing, vision loss, nails aren't growing, you got skin rashes, low testosterone, memory is shot. Then I would get your copper and zinc blood levels checked. You know, look at them, see what the ratio is there. And, you know, I think these is one thing where it's good to test them together versus just one or the other, because the ratio is really what makes all the difference. And this is another reason why, you know, I think blood vitality is so effective at raising iron stores, and people see such dramatic changes in symptoms without, you know, extreme dosing, because we're maintaining a balance of minerals and we're not just, you know, bludgeoning the body with one single mineral saying, oh, it's all about copper, oh, it's all about zinc, oh, it's all about iron, it's all about molybdenum. No, it's the balance that makes all the difference. It's the ratios that makes all the difference. And you can really make something toxic by throwing the ratio off of a particular mineral, or it could be the best thing ever for the body. So let me know any questions you have about zinc, copper, iron in the comments below. Also be sure to check out Blood Vitality if you do have, you know, iron deficiency issues and you're not getting where you want to get to. And then we also have the free optimizing iron guide below that you can check out. Man, stick with the whole stuff. Let your health blossom by sticking with whole foods in natural ratios.